Hello and welcome to the Join Dota League Season 13. I'm pretty sure this is the playoffs for Season 14. Or to go into Season 14 between... And I'm going to butcher this name. I'm going to butcher this name so hard. Rozbíječi and Team Panda. 5 seconds remaining. And we've got the bans coming out. The Bloodseeker, the Earth's being taken out. They're being played as a position 4 sometimes, I do believe. Strong core, as well as obviously now coming into that support position. Bit of an unorthodox one, but it is what the teams like to play. As the Necrophos, the Enchantress taken out there by the Radiant.
10 seconds remaining.
Bloodseeker as well, another one that's come back into fashion, I guess you'd say, with Eventual Spirit being the final ban out there by the Radiant. Yeah, the Bloodseeker...
Radiant team
just kind of came out of nowhere, and now it's here to stay. As the Crystal Maiden will be the first pick, did get a little bit of a nerf with the mana going back to 130, I do believe, 130, 150, 170, 200, was it? Something like that. Or maybe it maxes out 170, 130, 140, 150, 160, something like that. But it did get reversed, and now the mana on Crystal Nova is back up.
10 seconds remaining.
But teams still think she's a strong hero.
5 seconds remaining.
Aurora is pretty strong. Being able to get the talent as well, that plus mana. I think there's a negative on it as well if enemies get too close. So a bit of a mana drain there as well. Good,
Radiant
strong, solid hero.
Pudge.
As Pudge will be the first pick here by the Radiant. What are they going to be picking up next? I suppose that helps with the Crystal Maiden, because the Crystal Maiden, as soon as you start throwing out that freezing field... You throw your hook, drag her out of position, and just chop it to little tiny ice cubes.
10 seconds remaining.
So Roz.
5 seconds remaining.
Just counting down.
Dire team pick. Dire
Warlock.
The Undying.
The Warlock straight into the Undying. And... Yeah, again, excuse me. Undying, just a really strong with the Tombstone. You can disengage teamfights just by dropping that. Teams really have to commit to taking down that Tombstone or facing the wrath of the army of zombies. All the while Undying and his team can sit there and right-click you down, throw the spells at you, and you've got to be super picky and super decisive whether you stay in that fight or you just leave. Warlock Pudge, not
10 seconds
the fastest
remaining.
Of right clickers too, so the Tombstone so far won't be taken down
remaining.
All that quick. I mean, what the Phantom
Radiant
Lancer, Phoenix and Kunker being the three bans in the second phase, just waiting now for us to think about this last one. What are they, with the Undying, maybe not want to be playing up against here? Is Spectre a strong enough hero that you've got to ban it out? Because, I mean,
remaining.
She's getting up there in terms of power level.
5 seconds remaining.
And if you're banning out something like the Phantom Lancer, maybe you don't want to be taking the Spectre into the draft as well. So Roz, just ticking down the clock to having a bit of a team discussion about where they want to be going with the draft, maybe what they don't want.
Radiant team pick.
Okay, Broodmama. Always a good, solid ban. We did see that in the Southeast Asian scene, though, countered by the mid Meepo. Just being able to come in and absolutely destroy the Broodmama in the mid lane with those two Meepos and the Poofs. Couldn't get any real spider momentum.
Windranger at your service.
As Windranger starts to drop off slightly in terms of popularity, but is going to be drafted here by Roz. And again, still a great hero, I think. I think she's one of my favourites in the game. Just being able to do pretty much everything. Push down towers with the focus fire. She's got a lot of nuke damage. It did get a little bit of a nerf. I think it got minus 100 damage.
Five seconds.
Weaver.
Overall, this Weaver is going to be the pick by Team Panda. Good, strong fighter. Minus armor may even build into the Desolator as well to make it even stronger on that minus armor front. Being able to reset yourself in team fights as well, effectively giving yourself two lives as long as you don't get silenced, which is usually what you buy the Lincoln Sphere for.
10 seconds remaining.
So yeah, Silencer, Weaver. Remaining. Even Silencer could be picked up to try and deal with Weaver, but Weaver, good solid teamfighter hero, usually played in the off lane. I wonder if it's going to be in the off lane with the Undying. That's a quite powerful lane, being able to sap the strength and the health away from the line and the heroes, while the Weaver just carries on throwing out the minus armor and trying to right click them down with the swarm. But yeah, what did I leave off? Windranger, good solid hero. Lots of nuke damage. Lots of push potential with the focus fire onto the tower. Maybe if you go for an Aghanim Scepter, being able to hold two heroes in place and lock them down for 2-3 seconds.
Dire team pick.
And then just being able to escape as well. They pick up the Faceless Void. Going to go well with the Warlock as well as the Pudge. The Pudge being able to hook and dismember after or just as the Chronosphere starts to wear off. Power Shot, you can line it up easily when they can't move. And obviously Warlock, once the Chronosphere starts to get to its end of the duration, you throw the Warlock ult on top of it, drop that rock, as well as having a good setup for the Fatal Bonds. And Team Panda, as well as it revealing Invis Heroes. So, you know, if you catch the Weaver in the middle of a Sakuchi, it could be a good setup to start a team fight.
Radiant Team Ban.
Wraith King.
Panda pick up the Wraith King. Again, starting to see a little bit more popularity, maybe just because of the team fight potential. Obviously, you put it with the Crystal Maiden as well, you don't need to worry as much about saving that mana, which means more Wraith Fire Blasts before you get taken down, before you come back alive, which means even more Wraith Fire Blasts. And Team Panda
10 seconds remaining.
Opting to pick that one up.
5 seconds remaining.
And where are Roz going to go with this final ban? They've only got 5 seconds left on the reserve time. And they've still got a pick to come after. They ban out the Pugna, which could have foiled them. If you drop that Nether Ward, you know, there's a lot of spells there on the side of Roz's team. A decent amount of physical damage as well with the Wind Ranger, but you still need to cast that Focus Fire as well as the Faceless Void. But one good Pugna Ward can mess all that up for the Pudge and the Warlock, and sometimes the Wind Ranger as well. So Roz deciding that the Pugna is a little bit too strong. They don't want to be playing up against that. And he's out.
5 seconds remaining.
Of at least this draft. Well, Team Panda still have 48 seconds to think about this final pick. Just going to ban out the Monkey King. Maybe potentially an Axe to be picked up next.
Radiant team pick.
Tiny.
Going to be a tiny, tiny, tiny. Again, just seemed to drop off. It got a few nerfs, a couple reworks, and a little bit of a change in the Tiny. Just fell off the face of the earth, which is strange considering he's made of rock.
10 seconds remaining.
But obviously Five Team Panda, they have him remaining. In his strat. They have a strat around him and decide that the Tiny will be the pick as Clinks.
Choose your hero.
Will be the final pick by Roz. So, Hootie's going to be on the Windranger. We've got Hemi on the Faceless Void, Joshka on the Clinks, Palaki on the Warlock, and Breezy on the Pudge. Meal on the side of Team Panda. It's going to be Screen on the Crystal Maiden, Killer on the Undying, Gurren on the Weaver, TXN, or no, I've got nothing. It's just going to be VOTXN on the Wraith King, and Dabil. Just waiting for him to pick up his Tiny now. It's going to be interesting to see where they lane this on both sides, to be honest. Is it going to be the Windranger in the off lane, maybe with the Pudge, the Warlock in the safe lane, Faceless Void following up there, and the Clinks in the mid? And similarly on the side of Team Panda, I think it's going to be Wraith King. We have seen in the Southeast Asia, seen the Wraith King being a run in the off lane as well as another support. So maybe the Undying and the Wraith King in the off lane. Tiny Crystal Maiden in the safe, Weaver in the mid. But they can play around with the lanes a bit, and it might not be because it's done in the Southeast Asian scene. It might not be done in the European scene. So we could just see the Wraith King in the safe lane protected by someone like the Crystal Maiden looking for kills. In fact, Wraith King, Crystal Maiden, even in the offlane, it makes a lot more sense. Just because of the Crystal Nova slow, being able to follow up with the Wraith King's Wraith Blast. And, then a Frostbite around level 3, because usually the Crystal Maidens will opt for the Aura at level 2. So we are going to quick pause here at the beginning of the game, hopefully nothing too long. As we get the initial voice lines, sound lines being thrown out. I'm surprised it's not being spammed a little bit more. So yeah, with the Clinks getting a ward, I'm assuming this is going to be a mid Clinks. He's just going to be able to make his way straight to the mid lane. And look to get that ward down quick. Get some vision. Windranger in the off. Potentially though with the Pudge. She's already making her way over to the off lane. I'm assuming the Pudge is going to go with her. Just making it easy for them to look to harass down. Meanwhile, the Wraith King is starting to make his way over. I mean, I know he's only just coming out of the fountain, but it's looking like it's going to be the safe lane. And potentially the Crystal Maiden, once she gives one of those wards away, following up. Now, is it going to be Gurren or Dabil in the mid lane? Dabil's not picked up any items just yet. Weaver got himself the 6 tangos. So both teams, don't know why we paused.
Easy breezy.
But yeah, just throw out the lines, why not? Okay, we've got ourselves a go. So yeah, Pudge looking like he's gonna be going over to the off lane. Helping out the Windranger. Wendy, it's actually skilled up the Windrun, maybe just to get a little bit of momentum outside the fountain. Joshka gets himself down the ward in the mid lane. It looks like it's going to be the Tiny mid. Nice. So it's going to be a little bit harder to try and deal with this Tiny. Just compared to maybe the Weaver, who has a little bit more, well, in fact, doesn't even have more armor and has less health at the minute, thanks to the tower protection. Tiny's armor increased by 3.
30 seconds to battle.
Screen doing a little bit of scouts. I'm going to be coming across Palaki, and the right clicks trade do come out. There's going to be a double Crystal Nova now as well, but Warlock has his tangos coming up against Gurren. There's going to be the trades coming up, and meanwhile in the top river they're going to be doing a little bit of hijinks as they pull the Windranger, or they pull the Wraith King of the Undying using the Windranger. Meanwhile the Pudge will rotate round, look for the runes, but this could be 3 runes going the way, should be going the way of Team Panda.
This will come in handy.
Crystal Maiden already used a couple of Crystal Novas just to try and do a little bit of harass to Palaki, as well as the Faceless Void. Decent Observer Ward down there as well. It's looking for the pulls through. Oop, didn't want to ping that. But it's looking for the ping of the pulls. That's the Beal. Just taking a little bit of harass coming up with them Clinks. And obviously with them needing to come in close for those last hits. Fire arrows of the Clinks should be able to get Dabil down low. Though he's gonna salve himself up. Try and heal through that, and the arrow's not gonna try and cancel that one off. He's just gonna go straight back to the harass Mew in the top lane. Hootie's taking a little bit of harass coming through from Killer, throwing out those decays. But just gonna be able to tango himself up through the trees, trying to heal through though, tries to windrun his way from Killer. Wraith Fire Blast, a decay comes through onto just the Pudge. This could be first blood, should be. One more right click from either hero. The body blocks being there from Hootie. It's going to be enough for the salve onto Breezy. And the right click's now back onto Killer. Killer's going to be able to get the chase through. Gets another decay, but it's not going to be first blood. As the body blocks from Hootie, just enough to keep the Pudge alive. Avalanche comes through onto Joyka. And in fact, Tiny's top of the last hits. Not really got a lot of regen left though. Just one Tango and Fairy Fire. So Joshka is forced to pop the salve. But Dabil being forced back ever further. As there is no shrine now. For the next 3 minutes, just needs to buy himself another salve. Which will eat into his net worth. Screen, Crystal Nova comes out. Palocki could be in a little bit of trouble with the Scoochie as well as the right clicks. He's going to be throwing out the heal, but with the Shadow Word, is it going to be enough? It's just enough. Keeps him up on 30 health. And Gurren just couldn't chase. Time Walk into the trees. Crystal Nova comes out to Hemi though. Is he going to be able to? He's not going to be able to Time Walk himself away. Now he's looking a little bit trapped. This could actually be the first blood. He gets the bash onto Gurren. The chase either way. Screen's getting pretty down low as well. If it's a couple more damage, could tick down with the Fatal Bonds, but both heroes just get themselves out of range. But he's going to rotate from behind. Will be first blood. Screen does get taken down. And in fact, one of the creeps still hooked into the Fatal Bonds. We even got pretty low now as well. But Crystal Maiden will just reset after that death. TP yourself back into the lane. Meanwhile, mid lane, there was a hook onto the Tiny. Avalanche comes through onto the Pudge. And Clinks just couldn't follow up with the right clicks needed. Meanwhile, bottom lane, the Time Walk is going to get Hemi back to a decent amount of health. But he needs to be careful. Because no Time Walk for 10 seconds, and there's a lot of harass Radiant's that can come out. Is under attack. There's a Windranger with the pull. Undying trying to do what he can, only the first point into Soul Rip. So it's not the biggest heal in the world, or health shift. Depending on how you want to look at it. Hemi just looking for last hits. There's going to be the Fatal Bonds as well, but it only hooks to the creeps. So Screen not going to be taking too much damage coming out from that. Mural top lane, once again the chase is onto the Windranger. Windranger needs to be careful, 2 points into the power shot, but less than, well, it's now 300 health with that shift. No. The Wraith Fire Blast does come out, but there's not going to be any full up on this, and Hootie's just going to hang around trying to get some XP, maybe even looking for a deny here. And 19 last hits in the off lane, that's not too bad. Wraith Fire Blast once again, does have another Tango as well as a Fairy Fire and a Stick if you got too low. Now Hemi, the pull comes through, but it's going to be disrupted as the Frostbite, as well as the Crystal Nova, taking effect onto Hemi. But he is just able to time walk back, the Shadow Word now as well. Hemi should get himself up close to full health with another Tango. And yes, Screen, Fatal Bonds is there, but it's on a creep once again. The time walk forward, the time dilation as well, slowing him down. 12 seconds on the Crystal Nova. Not got a lot of mana as well. This could be a second kill going the way will be. And in fact, it's going to be Palocki that picks it up once more. No bash onto the Weaver. This Faceless Void is level 4. Level 5 on V. Yeah, ooh, mid lane. Tiny gets a return kill effectively onto the Clinks in the mid, and Breezy maybe just wandered off a little bit too soon. Crystal Maiden coming through from behind. Sakuchi sees Palocki in the swarm. Yeah, Shadow Word instantly popped. He's looking for that one now as well, just to keep him healthy. block. He just hides himself in the trees. And he carries on farming. Though, our timing's looking for stacks in here. He's got his tree. Just going to be moving into the jungle for stacks, but I'm not sure how much he's given up just missing farming this mid lane. Because the jungle ain't worth a great deal nowadays. And it does just free up the clinks to get a little bit of free XP. Look for denies as well. Meanwhile, top lane. Windranger, again, still taking the harass. The decay is still flying, draining the health from the Windranger, but it looks like the Crystal Maiden might go down for a third time. And this time, Himi is actually there to pick up the kill. Death is fulfillment. Gurren does get the return kill. 1 point into the swarm, one into the Germinate attack was enough to secure the kill. Meanwhile, they know now that Houthi should have, not a free lane, but should be able to get a little bit of a trade going with V. Just out of mana though. With the Breezy, it's going to drop a clarity onto the Windranger, just give her that little bit more of sustainability in the lane. Love to throw out another power shot. Maybe she goes to the shrine. Gets a heal on as well. Power shots through. Gonna be able to claim at least one jungle camp. Meanwhile, mid lane is the Pudge gonna be able to get himself a hook. Going for 2 points into the rot now, because you don't really need any more than 1 point into the hook early on. It's got the max distance at level one. V comes in, gets himself a deny. Maybe he's just going to throw another Wraith Fire Blast out. It connects onto the Windranger. You can't Windranger himself away from that too far. New on the mid lane, it looks like they're going to be able to get themselves a Clinks. The Shackle comes out, but it's not going to latch. And Dabil gets himself at least one kill. Is he going to be able to get himself another? He's got the toss coming up in the second, but it's going to go the way of screen. Palocki, though, takes down the Weaver on the bot lane. Power Shot comes through, splits the wickets between screen and Dabil. Windranger just looking to get a little bit out of this mid lane. While V just gets a free lane on top.
Rock'em, sock'em.
So Himi, how's he doing for farm? He is second in net worth, 400 behind the Wraith King. Whether he goes for the Battle Fury or not, there are stacks in the jungle that he could look to farm up, but the Wraith King with the skeletons will do it just that little bit much sooner. Unless, like I say, the Faceless Void does go for that Battle Fury. Dire's structures are fortified. Breezy, looking for an angle on the hook, but the skeletons are there just blocking the path. Meow Clinks, if we take a look at the hero levels, it is top of the hero levels. Well, Wraith King just takes over him. But the Tiny's looking for... I guess he's healing himself up. Is he looking for trades? Looking for kills? He's not for a smoke. You know, the ball lane. Faceless Void looking towards that level 7 now. Not too far off. Time walks himself forward. There's going to be the time dilation as well. A couple more right clicks onto Gurren. That should be the kill. He's taken down to the Shadow Word, but it won't be enough to secure the kill. And now three heroes down on the bottom lane. No time walk for the next second or so. Is it going to be there with the Frostbite? Just make sure he can't move away. And now four heroes, Palocki, and a whole load of trouble. The Fatal Bonds, but there's not going to be any follow-up damage. He is only level 5, so can't drop that rock just yet. And Pudge could be another one on the chopping block. Looks for the hook, gonna get the rune at least. So two runes going his way, but might give himself up with the avalanche toss back as well. Dabil picks himself up a regen. And this should be the chase waiting for the Crystal Nova as well as the Frostbite to come out onto Breezy. It's just not got enough mana to throw out both combos, but with Dabil here, the toss up into the air, one more right click. Gets himself another kill. Top lane, Fatal Bond, any shackles, not going to look like it as the Wraith Fire Blast does come out. Just maybe change in the timing on that Wind Ranger's kill. And Clinks just got himself a Blightstone, third in the net worth. Above the Tiny though, could be seeing the Undying, will see in the Undying. Any follow up to this? Doesn't look like it. Wraith King though, making quick work of the Warlock. Any rotations, Wind Rangers is just going to be using the time being bought to push down the tier 1 tower. But it looks like Palaki turns himself back. And once again, was that another Chronosphere? It looks like it was. Two kills down on this bottom lane, a carry and a mid laner. Pick that one up, Frostbite, not in time. Wind Ranger is able to TP yourself out there.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
I said Blightstone as well as a Seer and Arrows. They want to start on this tier 1 tower on the bot lane. Take a little bit more room away from the Weaver. The TP's going to come in though. The Strafe being thrown by Josh Kurt. It's going to be the Wraith Fire Blast onto the Faceless Void as well as the Avalanche Toss. Does have the time warp, but he doesn't have time to use it. Ironic for a Time Master. Your top lane, the Shackles to the tree. There's going to be the Focus Fire now as well. Screen will be taken down by the Wind Ranger. So net worth being traded back and forth. This tier 1 tower on the bot lane with the skeletons here. V should be able to claim this with the rest of his team. And it'll just make it that little bit harder for the Faceless Void to try and find the farm. He's already TP'd himself to the jungle. Gonna go for that Mask of Madness. And not opt-in for the Battle Fury this match. Maybe just goes for the Maelstrom after this. Just looking for attack speed and a little bit more magic damage to add to his build. No Chronosphere for 40 seconds or the build's coming across the tier 1 tower, but it looks like up on the top lane, Josh Kid doesn't want to stop pushing out this lane.
Dire's top tower is under
the Dire have a fortification. There's going to be the Strafe now as well, so Dire's this tier 2 tower down to just below. Or just above, sorry. Half health, the TP's going to come in. It looks like everybody on the side of the Radiant in this top lane wants to be making a move away, Josh. Yeah, it's going to go with the Ghost Walk as Warlock gets the TP away down to the bot lane. Weaver. It is going to be a Maelstrom for him. As Palaki's going to be able to get the deny, and nothing Gurren can do about that. Just with heroes effectively missing off the map, the Pudge rotated in as well. Ships in the night. One goes low, the other goes high. Hemi does have the Chronosphere back up now as well. As Dabil going to try and make a move. He's not too far off that blink. So maybe just looks for the farm. Hemi, I think, did he hear that Sakushi was? Definitely going to see Gurren now as well. But the time lapse back, just maybe trying to bait out the Chronosphere up into the middle lane. Josh is going to rotate through now as well. This Tiny should be taken out with the duo. And with the time dilation, one more right click. Hemi does get the kill, and Adjoshka needs to run himself away. Sakuchi, well, not going to be able to find it. Now that Time Walk just going to get himself down to the low ground. And Hemi should be able to get himself away from this as the tier 1 tower on the bot lane was taken. And Palaki even gets down a little bit of vision.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Warlock needs to be careful. He's being chased. But they are quite a while behind. It looks like the Maelstrom finished for the Weaver. Yeah, that's going to be coming out soon. Dust being used by Undying just to see if he can find a Clinks. But the tiny skeleton man already moved himself away. Pudge, dismember, gonna go onto the Tiny, the toss up into the air with the Avalanche. Well, the Shackle doesn't latch, but the power shot, Wind Ranger is still able to secure that kill. As Josh Kurt, seen by the ward, there's not gonna be any rotations onto him, it doesn't look like though. They are gonna come from behind, but should just be able to, well, maybe he doesn't see this coming. The Sakuchi there, it's gonna be onto the creep, so he should know he's gonna be able to get himself away. Sentry Ward is out of range of the dust. And Clinks will be able to get himself safely out. and up towards this tier 2 tower, which is being pushed in.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
Wraith King takes a tier 2 tower,
top tower is under attack.
But with no fortification, this should go down to the Radiant now as well. Yeah, the Clinks
Dire's
picks it up.
Top tower has fallen.
And do they just carry on pushing here? Focus fires there, Seer and Arrows, well it's not a lot of mana left. But it looks like they want to do something. The Avalanche Wraith Fire Blast combo comes in. Palaki throws out the Fatal Bonds, but I don't think there's going to be any follow-up. Is there going to be Chronosphere's up in 3 seconds? Will he drop the rock to try and buy time? Shadow Word just keeps him healthy, but he's trapped in with the... Oh no, the creeps trap him in. They betray him. Palaki looking to get himself out with the right-click Breeze. He gets himself a deny. And Dabil does finish off the Warlock. Faceless Void. Chronosphere's up. But he'd already left the potential scene of the team fight. So he just continues. He's gonna go for the BKB actually after the Mask of Madness.
Haste.
I suppose with the tiny as well screen on the Crystal Maiden, there is a lot of control. The Wraithfire Blast as well. To the Faceless Void. If he doesn't trap all of them, we'll stop him from being able to reach the full effectiveness. Oh, it's going to be a rock dropped on three. Any follow-up, the Fatal Bonds. Oh, they're going to be able to kill off the Crystal Maiden. Killer looks like he's going to be the next one to fall, as well as the Weaver with the Dismember. The right-click Joker takes his turn in three, and the blink away from the Tiny. Nothing to proc these Fatal Bonds. As the Beal, oh, the power shot. Just a little bit too far off to the right, but it is going to be three heroes on their own gank going down on the side of Team Panda. And that is not what you want when you go for an invade on the Radiant side. Pop a dust, find a Clinks. Do you see the Dabil though? TP's going to come in.
Top tower is under attack.
Looks like maybe they just want to start on Roshan, the side of Roz.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Breezy, the Wraith Fire Blast is going to miss because of the invis.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Top lane, Skeleton's trying to take this tier 2 tower. They might be able to just short 65 health, so the Wind Ranger is going to be able to get the deny.
Radiant's top tower has been denied.
Oh, he's seen under the sentry wall. There's going to be the Crystal Nova, the Frostbite now as well. Any follow up? Breezy just tries to walk himself away, but with the Avalanche and toss back. Pudge. Well, he's going to get himself dismembered and butchered as Killer is able to secure that kill. Gurren now will be able to finish off the Power Treads. That's the Beal. They see him. Is there going to be any follow up on this? Just get, yep, Chronosphere, edge of the Chronosphere, just barely. And that rock will crumble down for 38 seconds. Meanwhile, the Pudge is already back up looking for rotations through. He knows there's a sentry ward here now. Just pinging it out onto the high ground of the Warlock. Is he going to be able to get this? Nowhere near, unfortunately. They overlap, but will not see each other. Wraith King, any vision on this? They're going to see the Crystal Maiden, though. Is Crystal Maiden going to see the Clinks? Pops the dust. There's going to be the Flesh Golem going to come through, but it's too late. They take down screen just to slow down by the Diffusal Blade. It's going to be a dismember onto the Wraith King before he can get a good double shackle as well. The Power Shot comes in. Just good. He's going to be able to get himself away. No more dust. I think it's worn off. He's going to be able to skeleton walk himself out of this. And Breezy will be the sacrificial lamb.
My just reward.
Time. So, not the worst fight there for Team Panda. Taking down the Pudge and only trading off a Crystal Maiden for it. Who is bottom of the net worth. So not a whole lot gained out of that. Faceless Void's actually opting for the Lincoln Sphere next, so swaps himself off from the BKB. Just wants to make sure he can get himself a jump in. as we get a quick pause, get himself a jump in, get the chronosphere off, and start doing work inside the chronosphere. Take a look at the items while we have a quick break. Armlet onto V. Yeah, armlet blink dagger, pretty standard there for a Wraith King. Gurin. It's actually gonna go for the Aeon Disc over the Lincoln Sphere. As we have the tips, it's on their own teams. That's alright, that's fine. You know, no BM in there. Joshka does have himself a Diffusal Blade. So, Utin Palaki in the mid lane. Maelstrom picked up there by the Wind Ranger. I wonder if she's going to go. In fact, nothing coming out on the courier. I wonder if she's going to go for that Agrim Scepter afterwards. Starting to save the money for it, maybe. We got ourselves on pause. Yes, it was only a quick one. As mid lane, Dabil starts to come forward with nobody else on his team behind him.
That is
dangerous. He's just on the edge of the scan there as well, so they can't actually see him. He's trying to wait for somebody to come forward to try and blow them up, I guess, but now he gets the backup. Now the rest of his team is here just in case. Just in case someone comes forward and he can get the blink on and get a kill. Do you see the Wind Ranger? There's going to be the Frostbite. Is it going to be a blink avalanche toss combo going to come in? The Freezing Field's there as well. Rock is dropped, but it looks like they're going to try and run this one away. No, baby. The buyback coming through from the Wind Ranger. And now the Shackle onto the trees as well. Any follow up through? There's going to be the Searing Arrows. V. Well, the Chronosphere, but V is out of it. The takedown. The Crystal Maiden, as the Weaver does move himself back into that. The Pudge even buys back for this now as well. This is a team fight they want to try and win. Wraith King does still have the Reincarnate. He's moving himself over towards... Well, let's take a look at this team fight first. The Shackle's going to be off the mark because of the time. He's going to be able to do damage here. Does he have the Avalanche Toss combo? He's going to be able to toss back a zombie onto the Clinks, but it's going to be four kills. As well as his Tombstone going the way of Roz. Off, what was that, two buybacks? Yeah. And now, they even got the Reincarnate kill onto the Wraith King. So slowing him down on that Radiance. And now Roshan will be started. And Crystal Maiden, thank you for the helping hand. But oof, the hook as well. That was a little bit off the mark. Palaki's gonna go for the chase. The Lincoln Spear is popped with the Shackle Shot. Just keeping Roshan, but the blink forward by Hooty. Is he gonna be able to get the kill here? The slow down with this upheaval screen just hides himself in the trees. Power Shot, the Doocy screen now. He's moving slower and slower and slower. The Frostbite comes through. The Shackle onto the Undyne as well. Any follow up? Well, there's gonna be a hook. And Breezy gets that kill. Do they carry on going? The BKB's there now. It's going to be popped by Hemi. He's not actually picked up the Aegis. Who picked it up? It's going to be the Clinks. And a Breezy will be killed off. But once again, Roz take a great trade. 19 to 16. It's only a 4k net worth lead though. You know, it's not too far ahead of Joshka. Now gets himself a BKB as well. Tiny, the time walk forward to be able to blinks on. The blink comes through from the Wind Ranger. He's going to be able to TP himself away in the Shadow. Or the Shadow Amulet used attack. Just at least from the Tiny. As it looks like Plocky stops to use the Shadow Word. But he will be killed off. And nothing that he could really do about that once he'd stopped. Tier 2 tower will go down in the mid lane.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Windranger just looking for the power shots to carry on pushing this out. Sharkle, it does latch, but he doesn't have any reveal. So the Weaver will survive through this. Even the focus fire being used there, down for the next 60 seconds. The hook back in onto the Undying though. Any follow-up on this? Well, Hemi's there, the Dismember as well. Time walks himself away, just in case there was any big follow-ups. Or he blinks in by a certain Rockman. On the chase, but it looks like the Windranger is going to go for the BKB now as well, not opting actually for that Aghanim Scepter. Tabeel trying to do what he can, moving around in this Shadow Amulet, but obviously not a lot of mobility there, just forced to keep himself in biz. Looking for maybe to come on, someone to come up and try and deal with that.
Dire's but middle tower is under attack.
In the end, he gives up. Just going to be walking himself away. Tier 2 tower in the mid lane. There's no fortification, so this Tier 2 tower will easily be dispatched by the Radiant.
A golden thread.
And do they want to carry on? They've still got themselves an Aegis. They've got themselves a Chronosphere. Rock is available to be dropped. TP in. Do they go for the Wraith King? The hook's going to be off the mark. And V does have himself the Reincarnate. As it looks like Tiny just might try and skip the lane here. The chase is on onto the Weaver though. Any blink onto the high ground, it's not going to be up for the next 5 seconds or so. Gurren, the Windranger though, goes north while Gurren dips south. Clinks gets the kill onto Killer. The Killer Killer. Ooh, Wraith Fireblast onto V now as well. The skeletons are going to follow up. The Time Walk just gets himself healthy again and screen. Any right clicks, it's going to be an uphill miss. And the chase doesn't come out. Hemi though. Wraith Fireblast just as the Time Walk ends. And the Radiance will help the team. Just a little bit of a mischance there. So, Faceless Void with those bashes won't be as effective as normal. As Tiny carries on hiding himself in Viz. Just looking for that perfect pickoff.
Illusion.
He does have himself the full Shadow Blade now. It looks like it's going to be coming out on the Courier. Maybe. The scan, they see him even with the Shadow Amulet. Do they get any reveal on this? The Stomp, they've got to know someone's there with the neutrals, but Amy just lets him go. No dust to reveal him. And nothing they can do. There was a sentry. Was that? Was he just out of range of the sentry?
Dire are scanning.
So Tiny got himself out safe. Just again, just looking for these pickoffs, but it means he's not firm and he's dropping down the net worth. Well, he got himself 100 last hits compared to the 188 that's still stacking up on the Clinks. Could find the kill onto Joshka though. Joshka, does he walk himself into this? Any follow up? Is he going to go for it? The invis wears off now. He gets the right click just a little bit too late. And Joshka just going to be able to skeleton walk as well. He's going to carry on chasing. There's going to be the defusal blade, the blink forward onto the Tiny now as well. So Tabeel gets himself out safe and the Aegis has been reclaimed. 3-man smoke comes through the Radiant Jungle. It's going to be popped. The Sakuchi wears off now as well. The time lapse, the Chronosphere comes out just a little bit too late. Oh, it's down for 130 seconds. And a big part of the team fight gone from the side of Roz. And now the Flesh Golem comes out. It looks like they maybe want to carry on chasing this. Palaki Tomb's going to be dropped. The TP away. Nothing to cancel this. So Weaver can't follow up the kill onto the Warlock. The Time Walk away now on Hemi. Looks like Pudge's going to TP. The BKB stops the Avalanche. And now the Time Dilation. But Dabeel just gets himself in this. And at a little bit of a cost, Roz do get themselves away from that. So Clicks, just looking to push out this top lane. Shrine used by Dabil. But Clinks isn't going to stay around too long. Maybe they need the TP was there. The Shackle comes out onto the Undying. The hook back. Breezy secures that kill. And Undying goes for a dirt nap. Probably his favourite kind of nap. But still. It's going to be a quick one. Back up in 30 seconds. Joshka just looking to scout around. They may see the weave of the hook. Her line, or whatever Weaver's made out of line, away from being able to hook back and get that dismember off. Exoskeleton line? Antenna line? Anyway, Dabil, with the Shadow Blade. He's moving himself in, pushing the lane out, and then just moving himself back out. He's going to be able to get himself through now as well. Budge. He's got himself 8 time flesh sheeps. 3 points in that already. Bottom tower is under attack. As foretold. Where's Faceless Void going to go with this now? He's building himself. Is that the MKB? It looks like it. Chronosphere is available. Will the Weaver show? Well, Joshka scouts it out. I know the Chronosphere. No time for the time lapse. But the bashes is for enough damage. Joshka was caught up in the Chronosphere. Meanwhile, the mid lane, it's going to be the Pudge getting the deny. The time walk forward. Time dilation to slow down V now as well. Wraith Fire Blast. He does have the reincarnation. Shackles to the creeps. His own skeletons betray him. Hemi pops the BKB, just trying to get himself fired. But there's going to be the rock being dropped. He should be able to take down this Wraith King once more, being slowed down by the upheaval. Joshka, well, the dust slows him down. Power shot's going to be off the mark. I think he's going to be able to get this kill onto V with the Wraith Fire Blast comes out. The Freezing Field now as well. It looks like V's getting pretty low. But Killer gets the kill onto Palaki. And the power shot's just not on the mark. The toss up into the air now. But the shackle to the trees. It could be the Windranger with the charges. One more right click. Joshka able to get himself in there. Save his teammate and secure the kill onto Dabil. Screen, you need to be careful. You need to be so careful. Oof. The dust reveal onto the Crystal Maiden as well. Though Seer even gets the pullback onto the Undying. Meanwhile, are they going to be able to take down the Wraith King? He does have his reincarnate back up. Weaver, though, is going to try and come in helping out his teammate. The Chronosphere will face this void just on the end of that to do the extra damage. V heals himself up with the urn, it looks like. They take down Breezy, but it will be a full 5-man wipe. Oh, Gurren, the power shot's just going to be off the mark. Can he get the kill, though? Hootie with a blink dagger will be able to secure it. I'm going to say that counts. Tiny only just came back up. That counts as a 5-man. It's Clinks now. Is he looking for the sheepstick? Will help him deal with the Wraith King as well as the Weaver. The Weaver not opted for. It was the time lapse that healed up the Wraith King. But with no Lincoln Sphere, Weaver is an easy target for something like a Sheepstick to help take him down quickly. Or in conjunction with something like a Chronosphere, maybe? I don't know. Tiny looking to push out the bot lane with his tree. But Pudge has rotated down. No rock for 36, Chronosphere up in 48. The upheaval though. Acting like a canary in a coal mine. If anyone wants on Palaki, they were one, slowed by the upheaval, even if they did blink themselves down, and two, then the Radiant know they're coming. It puts themselves in a better position to try and react to the fight. Hemi, what one? Oof, it looks like Dabil's wears off last. Stops for the right click though. Hemi's there. The avalanche being thrown out. The Mask of Madness to toss back onto the creeps though. So there's no time walk forward, at least for the next 2 seconds or so. There's a hook. He went fishing. But all he caught was a. Reaver though, Gurren's gonna come in. There's gonna be the Wraith Fire Blast, the Invis from the Faceless Void just before he stunned up. Upheaval now as well, Suguchi wears off. There is a Chronosphere if they wanna try and drop it. Chronosphere comes out, the damage should be there now as well. With the Focus Fire, even with being hauled up, the rock drops, the Reincarnate's there. But is it gonna be enough as he looks to take down the Tombstone? Wraith King tries to get himself away with the Glimmer Cape. Is the chase going to be on? Well, they are going to be able to take down the Undying, at least now, with the Sheep Stick coming out as well. Wraith King, is there going to be a Shackle? Well, they're just going to save it. He throws the Wraith Fire Blast out. Might even be able to take down the Faceless Void. Shackle thrown now. And Reincarnation is going to be coming up, but not before the Faceless Void does die. And now the Avalanche Toss combo. Wind Ranger goes invis, but still gets taken down by the Tree Toss. Backlines, they take down the Crystal Maiden. And maybe that kill on the Faceless Void could have been avoided if it could have been a quicker Shackle. But it's a 4-for-3 at the minute. The Blade Mail comes out. The Hex once again onto the Wraith King. And now the Recklessly Slowdown by the Diffusal Blade as well. This should be a kill with the Dismember onto the Tiny. Are they going to be able to get the kill onto Breezy? Well, V doesn't want to risk it. He's not got the Reincarnation for 5 seconds. So doesn't want to dive too deep. And Pudge will be able to get himself away, heal himself up.
Death tax
for the treasury. All mine. Get over here, fresh mate.
The Pudge gets himself a hook onto Killer. Finds himself a kill there as well. Breezy even getting a little cheeky, hooking back Palaki. Plink's just looking for a bit more farm, looking for an MKB himself. How far did Hemi get with that? Actually changed his mind, gonna be going for a butterfly, maybe to try and avoid those crits coming out from the Wraith King. Those deadly, deadly crits. The Hex onto screen. Joshka is going to be able to get himself a kill. Some skeletons for his trouble. Maybe trying to take the place of the Lord of Bones. Vito with a blink. Shadow Blade onto the Tiny. If Joshka doesn't run himself away now, there's a gem. And maybe decide to back up. It was only the Warlock. But that's, they want to know that. Not knowing where the Pudge and the Faceless Void were, coming to back up Joshka. Sees that Observer Ward, but they just don't have any vision on it. Faceless Void up to the high ground. Is there any reveal? There's not. The Beal's going to see two. He's got himself a gem, so he can't see the Clinks, as the MKB is finished now. Shadowblade about to wear off. Clinks goes invis and Dabil just runs for it. The gem is there, the Avalanche, Wraith Fire Blast, Chronosphere. Well, it's going to be the blink and Hemi's baiting it. But the age, what is that? Is that a talent? It looks like they are going to be able to take down screen at least. Now the rock being dropped. Can they take down V as he gets time lapse back before they take down the Faceless Void? The combo up on the top lane. The time dilation now as well. Dabil, it's going to be the time walk away. They're trying to focus down. It's Wraith King. But is he going to be able to kill off? He's going to be able to get the Reincarnation. It's Breezy. Just looks for an eye. Killer takes him down. And on the back lines, the Shackle's not going to last you anyone. Dabil goes invis. Are they going to be able to get the kill? Clinks gets taken down. And Killer's got himself a double. As well as a couple of watts. They did take down the Wraith King, but Reincarnation comes through. And the Wraith King now looking for the full Abyssal Blade. Now we're getting map drawings.
Rock'em, Sock'em. Look at that.
Huti, is he gonna be able to see Killer? Power shots into the creep wave and Killer just instantly thinks twice. He backs his solar crest and just... Is he gonna go for the back out here? As they drop a ward. The pings are there, but Killer, it's already away.
My belly bursts.
Faceless, no chronosphere up for the next 46 seconds.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Yeah, just needs to hang back. That's a big part of the team fight down. Huti's opting for the MKB. The upheaval's going to come. Does it try and scare V off? Well, Tombstone dropped. And the zombies, the blink forward though, onto the Warlock. Are they going to be able to get this kill? Or at least V is going to be able to get this kill. He does have the reincarnate, even if he dives a little bit too deep, slow down by the Diffusal Blade. Looks like it was purged off. Should be fine. They take a tier 3 tower in the mid lane, and V looking for these mid lanes of racks. Once again, just leading the line. And Clinks, I was looking at that.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Yeah, it must have been the Aegis, right? Toss up the kill off the Windranger, who instantly buys back. It's going to be a four-man Chronosphere. The Fatal Bonds, do they have the rock? It's not going to be up for the next 48 seconds, but they are going to be able to get kills. Reincarnates, can they take down Dabil? He will be burst down the... Himi's got himself a double, and now the chase is on with that Sheepstick onto V. Joshka secures the kill, the blink forward onto Killer, the shackle to the trees. And he should be able to take him down. And that's the fight that Roz needed. Can they look for the push up the mid lane though?
Double damage!
Time is money.
Dire structures are
and that was the summon golem on death. Yeah, the toss combination. Are they going to be able to kill off the Clinks, who throws out the Sheepstick onto the Tiny? He's trying to run himself away. He's got the Shadow Word to keep himself healthy as well, but the Swarm has been slowed down with the Diffusal Blade. Tries to turn, do much damage he can to Dabil. Are they going to be able to get the kill? The hook away. That one more right click flies through the air, and Joshka might even survive. Will survive as they get the two kills onto the Tiny as well as the Weaver. Oh boy, what a turnaround just from that hook. Dabil might have died, but they should have been able to get the kill if it wasn't for that hook onto the Clinks. And Breezy, just showing that he is absolutely on top at the minute playing this Pudge.
Dire's middle tower.
Mid lane's going to be pushed in. The tier 3 tower's going to take a fall. Yeah, there should be at least a melee Rax. The Wraith King is going to be coming back up to. They rotate off to the top now as well. Looks like they might go for the focus fire. They're just going to go for the tier 4s. It's going to be a dismember onto the Undying now as well. Any follow up? Well, the right clicks, they bash him down. The tombstone's been dropped, but there is a Chronosphere. He's instantly going to be buying back. With only 3 heroes, Freezing Field takes no effect. Chronosphere comes out onto the Crystal Maiden now as well. So Himi's just looking for the kill. The Soul Rapids are going to be able enough to keep him alive. Screen still survives for now. They take down Breezy. Wraith King could be using the Reincarnate. Screen, I don't know how he's surviving through this. They take down the Undying, who's already bought back. And now the Reincarnate comes up for V. The buyback, though, onto the Faceless Void. They kill off the Wraith King. The dust is popped. Screen will take a fall. Wraith King buys back, but it's only 2 heroes against 5. It looks like the side of Roz, they want to be trying to end this game now with the 2 golems. With a push in, they take the Crystal Maiden with the Dismember. Any follow-up onto this? The hook back. Screen trying to do what he can with the Frostbite. Looks like the rotation is going to be coming in. It's going to be the kill onto the Crystal Maiden once again, who has just died back. And with only Wraith King, well, you've got 2 heroes coming back up in the form of a
Dire's
Weaver.
Bottom shrine is under attack.
As well as a Tiny, but worth it for the buybacks.
Regeneration.
3 buybacks either side.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
And now Dabil is invis, but Roshan has been started. Cheese bottom still on the ground. Somebody go pick up the cheese, please. T- tiny, moving himself forward towards the Wind Ranger, but once again he's so far out from the rest of his team. If you get vision on this, this is a broken pebble. Just waiting to happen. Might go for the blink combination. How much health has he got? He's got 3k health. 15 armor. Not 12 armor now.
Invisibility!
Chronosphere's there, Butterfly as well. Chi's being picked up by the Faceless Void. He's got himself an MKB queued up as well. Fourth in the net worth, did the Wind Ranger. No, it's actually just going to be, yeah, it looks like it's going to be the Daedalus picked up the MKB. So no Item Scepter there for the Wind Ranger.
Radiant are scanning.
Smoke up on the side of Team Panda. But I don't think they're going to be able to find anything here. Nobody's even close. Roshan's already been taken, and the full five-man lineup of Roz up in the top left corner of the map. Now the smokes break onto Breezy, but Breezy's got 4.5k health. You get the Chronosphere onto at least the Undying. At the time lapse, are they going to be able to get this kill? They should be able to get it, even with the Soul Rip screen gets taken down there by the Wind Ranger. The chase on the back lines, the Hex come through. It's going to be the Reincarnate as Hemi does take down the Undying. And now back to this rock going to be dropped to. Can they kill off Breezy? Will be able to kill off Breezy. Hemi just working on that tombstone. Time walks himself forward, takes down the time lapse, saves the Wraith King's life. But is it going to be for. It looks like with the time walk forward, they should just be able to get the Hex. The kill onto this Wraith King. So the time lapse bought him time. The time lapse bought him time. But in the end, it was not enough. And yeah, four heroes down. Roz just looking for the tier 3 on the top lane.
Radiant's middle barracks are under attack. Radiant structures are.
Gurren, I don't think, can hold out long enough on his own to try and stop this. And with a golem as well, it is going to be going down in the next 10 seconds, but should be able to do at least
Dire's
one swipe.
Top tower is under attack.
Okay, they're just going to go for tier 4, so the golem's not going to do anything. Tier 4 gets taken down, there's going to be a shackle. Undying gets the tombstone off because of his death. Frostbite, Crystal Nova takes down Hootie at least. Well, they're starting on the Ancients. The Rock's going to be dropped onto two of them as well. Now the Hex onto the Weaver. Are they going to try and change focus? Get this kill. Should be able to get it. Upheaval slows down the Crystal Maiden, but it looks like the Ancient will fall. A couple more right clicks after the fortification wears off. And this will be another Rock. Yeah, GG goes the way of Roz for game number one. Is a best of three though, guys. So, Team Panda have the chance to get back into it. Roz want to be taking this momentum through, make this series a 2-0 in the first round of the qualifiers for the Premier Division of the Join Dota League. I've been your cast and Rob and Roll Gaming. Stick around, we're going to take a quick break. We'll be back with game number two quite shortly.